Okay, this is going to be a bit of a long video because I'm going to listen to two Tool songs, and if you know Tool, they don't write short songs. But they've got a new song out, which is Opiate², which is a reimagining of a song of theirs called Opiate from many, many, many years ago. And I actually am not familiar with the original, so I need to listen to that first, probably, to then listen to the new one. I'm a big fan of Tool, but from like the Anima album onwards. The last four albums have been very enjoyable, particularly Anima Lateralis, 10,000 Days. Those are amazing. Fear Inoculum was a work of musical genius, but I don't find myself like coming back for more listens to that one the same way I do with other ones. But their very, very early work, I kind of haven't checked out, which is on me. That's on me. I don't know. I think any time I try to listen to it, the production levels have not been like as exciting. And it just makes me want to listen to the Tool songs I like more. Instead of that, so I've kind of avoided them. But because they've done this Opiate², all right, I shall listen to Opiate. I don't know how to pronounce that correctly. So here we go. So this was apparently off a kind of an EP, which had Sweat, Hush, Part of Me, Cold and Ugly, Jerk Off Live, and Opiate. This was in 1992, very long time ago. If you don't want to listen to the reaction-y thing for Opiate and just want to go to Opiate², don't worry. I'm going to timestamp the video. You can skip right ahead. But I feel like I need to listen to this one in order to understand the new one. I imagine. Who knows? Maybe I don't need to. Either way, 8 minutes, 31 seconds for the first one, Opiate, and go.
Strong to guide you.
Yeah, the production levels not as good as it is these days, but they had more groove in the olden days. Much more stripped back, it's just drums, bass, guitar, vocals, less atmospheric additions. Very soft open hi-hat. It sounds a lot more like kind of grunge, like your Pearl Jam. It's very much Tool, but it's, you can hear it's the early phase. We took a turn. Sounds like Rage Against the Machine here. Danny Carey on the drums. Sounds like Nirvana. I guess 92, that makes sense.
Jesus Christ, why don't you come save my life now?
It's really of its time. The essence of what I love about Maynard is in here. There's a lot more vocal involvement than in like the most recent album. The vocals are much less involved there. This sounds more like the kind of Tool soundscape that I'm used to. Kind of an echoing, swirling, panning back and forth vocal. That's cool. Yeah. or actually the production. There's a subtle multi-vocal track, but mostly there's one that's in the center. Note. Okay. That bass note that just rings out. Sort of clumsy. Works. This sounds like lateralis drums. Ticks and leeches. Great screen. Ah. He's just sustaining it. Nice. Gosh. Imagine hearing this back in 1992. You'd be like, I'm going to listen to everything this band ever does. This is fucking cool. Kind of tribal drumming. Sudden rhythmic change, but everyone else followed. There's a lot of time left in this, but it's so quiet. Is this when there's like no sound for the next 3 minutes? I just sit here and wait. How do you end a song with that? Come on. Why are there 3 more minutes? I have to wait and see. Maybe music's gonna come back. There's 3 fucking minutes to go. Well, 2.5 now.
I had a friend once, he took some acid. Now he thinks he's a fire engine.
This is very Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas. Trippy. They did all kinds of stuff with the production to make the drum sound to something really far away. Guitar tone is kind of sliding around. They must have been really high
sort of loving,
when they did this.
Caring, kinda tried to fuck my lazy boy. It got a bit messy all over the curtains, armchair covers, throw pillows and carpeting.
Sort of sounds like the Doors, kind of an era of psychedelic rock. Okay. Well, I'm glad I didn't just sit with silence for 3 minutes. They did go into some other stuff. But it was separate from the main Opiate song, as I would call it, a Tool song. That sounded like a kind of... Maybe that was like the EP's outro, because Opiate seemed to be the last song on that record, so... That was a choice. Excuse me. I'm still coming back from yet another, like, heavy cold illness thing. All right. That was cool. I liked Opiate a lot. It had a lot more vocal involvement than the more recent Tool songs did. And I love Maynard's voice. And I think anytime that he's present in a section of one of their songs, it's elevated beyond what it would be when it's just the musicians, for the most part. I like moments when Danny Carey, the drummer, can shine and do some drum fills with nothing else going on. But that was cool. A lot to like. But it was simpler. It was more, you know, straight-laced, stripped-back kind of rock, grunge sort of vibe to it. Whereas now, since then, Tool have been much more experimental and unusual. Which, somewhere between the start of that song and what they did at the end of that song, Tool are in the middle of that these days. So, I've got a new song, Opiate Squared. This is almost 10 minutes long. And I wonder if they're going to do anything about that weird psychedelic outro bit, or who knows? They could do something completely different. I'm excited to check it out. Without further ado, and go. Beautiful. I'm enjoying the higher level of production on this already. Better recording techniques. Always were a problem for you. Crystal clear vocal. What you need is someone strong to guide you. The production's amazing. So much fuller with guitars. You can hear more of what the bass line is doing because of the way it's recorded, mixed. That's delicious. The hi-hats are crisper, less soft, kind of washy. Maybe that's the recording ability, or maybe that's the way he's playing it. What you need is someone strong to guide you. The vocal delivery is very similar. He hasn't really lost that grit yet. That same chord. And then stop. Love it. So far, it's really honoring the first one. It's just a better recording. The drum microphones are clearly a lot better now. They're clearer tones. Yes, Danny. Ah. Gorgeous guitar tone. Clean, bit of herb. Really nice. Crisp little hi-hat getting close by his foot. he's doing those kind of like tom-toms, I don't know what they were called. The drummer's drum kit setup is wild. I don't remember all these details in the first one. Percussion-wise. I mean, he will have expanded his kit since then, probably. This feels like an extended part. I don't remember this being that long in the first one. It's definitely new percussive sounds. It's beautiful. Oh yeah. Got such a rich tapestry of percussive sounds at his fingertips, Danny Carey, like drum-wise, but also some odd like sounds. There's like a jar of pencils. Like there's all kinds of things in it. That guitar sound, that lead guitar sound, is very sort of Fear Inoculum. Cool, it really bridges the gap between where they are now and where they were in 92. Mmm. Delicious. Yeah, this is definitely extended. It wasn't like this in the first one. Ugh. Busyness of double kick drum pedals in there. Bit of groove building up. Oh, it's going off. And the guitarist generates such a Tool sound. You know exactly who this is just by listening to his tone. Choice of notes. Love the simplicity of it. After all that chaos. Leaning in. Again, with that subtle additional vocal that kind of pans around. Tempo slowed down there. Hey, slowed the tempo, that's cool. There's the scrape. There's additional scrape vocals in there as well. That's cool. This is a lot closer to that raw production of the first one, somehow. There aren't extra elements added in, it's just guitar, bass, drums. No snare drum hits in this, it's just around the toms. Yeah. Sustain a bit, but there clearly won't be that psychedelic ending like we had in the first one. Okay, well, that was an experience. That was cool. What was interesting about that is I had no idea what they were going to do with that first song. It was in some ways a reimagining. Like there was that extended instrumental in the middle, which was existed in the first one, but not to that level. But everything else was the essential, just the same stuff from the first song, just better recording techniques, better production on it. Additional drum elements, because he's got a different drum kit now. They'll have, you know, more modern like pedals and distortion sounds and stuff for the guitars. But vocally, pretty much the same delivery on everything, including like the multi-track vocal stuff, with the kind of background panning vocal. So it was cool. Like, they kept very much the same essence of what you would like from their original, but expanded on that section in the middle. They dropped the strange psychedelic ending weirdness, the Doors style at the end. So Opiate is just that main song at the start, I've learned. I didn't know. But it was cool. Yeah, and for me, it bridged that gap between Opiate is a very straightforward kind of, as Tool goes, rock song from 1992. But they, you know, they bridge the gap between that sound and what they do more recently with their new kind of production levels and expressions and instrumentals. And sort of, it spanned the era of Tool in this one expression of Opiate Squared, which I really liked. I thought that was great. I'm glad they did that. It must be the kind of band that they don't really do what people want them to do necessarily. They don't conform to, you know, a single doesn't necessarily have over 6 minutes long, but they do that all the time. So they don't really care about that. So I'm kind of surprised that they saw fit to re-record something they did a long time ago, because it's the kind of thing that I would have thought they would resist and be like, no, that song was perfect in 1992 and we don't want to change it. So it's a really interesting choice that they decided to come and revisit this and expand on it in that way, but for the rest of it, kind of re-record it exactly as it was. I'm here for it, man. I enjoyed that. I always enjoy hearing some new Tool music, even though it's an old song, but it was new to me because I didn't listen to the old song before today. That was cool. I like it. Thank you, Tool, for some new music in 2022. Much appreciated. Thanks to Craig Billow for giving the nudge to let me know that this came out, because I was unaware. Thanks for that. I enjoyed that. That was what? It was almost half an hour's worth of listening to music. Cool, why not, man? Anyway, hopefully you enjoyed that. When Tool release new music, not just reimagine stuff, I will absolutely check it out, because I'm a big fan of Tool. So hopefully, the problem is, knowing Tool, the next album they release will be in about 10 years' time. But otherwise, I do love me some Tool. Hope you enjoyed this video and this reaction thing. If you want to see more from me, feel free. Otherwise, have a wonderful day. Maybe I'll see you in another video.